The Philippine Stock Exchange begins the week in the red. The main index was down by close to 0.7% to close at 65.44. Value turnover was at 25.5 billion pesos. Now to help us make sense of today's market movements, we're joined by Japet Antianco, Research Manager of PhilStox Financial. Japet, thanks again for joining us.
Good afternoon, Sir Stanley. Thank you very much for having me.
All right, now we've seen how markets are reacting to the SVB developments. Locally, we're seeing banks and financials also dipping the most among other counters. But we're hoping that this is both knee-jerk and short-term. Now, while local banks may not be operating the same way as SVB, this incident, of course, underscores the need for better corporate governance. Now, how confident are you that our banks are well-supported by policy in order for these not to find themselves in a similar situation as SVB and even Signature Bank?
Well, if you're going to look at our banks right now, if you're going to look at their latest financial results, you'll see that our banks are the quality of the assets of our banks remain robust. If you're going to look at non-performing loans ratios, they have been declining. Non-NPL coverage ratios have been healthy so far. At the same time, capital adequacy ratios remain well above the BSP's requirements. With these, we can see that our banks so far have good defenses against asset risks. And I believe that the BSP has good regulatory measures that are protecting our banks and the financial system as a whole. And second, if you're going to look at SVB, if you're going to look at its client base, it's mostly startup companies, right, which are now taking a heavy hit from the rising interest rate environment in the US. You compare that to our Philippine banks, most the clients of our Philippine banks are well diversified, from consumers to corporates. Mm. And at the same time, if you're going to look at the Philippine economy, it's in a relatively better position compared to the US, growth-wise. And with that, I believe that the Philippine banks will still be able to maintain a strong deposit base, and at the same time, will continue the growth in its loan portfolios.
All right, now Japet, markets seem to be fixated too much right now on what happened to the two U.S. banks. With the Fed meeting upcoming and the other data, particularly U.S. CPI coming out, and of course our own policy meetings from the BSP, do you think this trend of pessimism would persist in the coming week, given all of these negative developments?
Sadly, yes, it's a possibility. Right now, we're seeing the local market trading with a downward bias, moving forward. First and foremost, because of the issues in the U.S. financial system, which is spilling over to the rest of the world. And at the same time, you do have this U.S. February inflation rate coming up. And I believe this is what investors are fixing their focus on right now. January inflation rate was 6.4. If February inflation rate in the U.S. exceeds the 6.4%, then this could spell more declines for the local boards, because a strong inflation rate in the U.S., especially one that beats the 6.4%, it may lead to a more aggressive rate hikes by the Federal Reserve, which of course is going to be negative for the market. So I believe that's what investors are looking forward to right now. Mm-hmm. If February inflation is higher than January, then my expectation is that the market will further decline this week.
All right. Now, while many are maintaining a hands-off stance on financial sectors for now, while waiting, of course, for the resolution of issues in the U.S. banking system, which counters do you see are benefiting from at least a temporary shift in investor interests for now?
Well, if you're going to look at the market performance today, the only gainer was the conglomerates.
Right.
So I believe they're the ones benefiting right now. And this can be attributed to bargain hunting. Last week, the conglomerate subsector was the second top loser in the market. Mm. We've seen a lot of conglomerate index members that have been sold off heavily. So I believe there's been bargain hunting today, bargain hunting in the conglomerate or in the holdings front. So they're the main beneficiaries. But overall, if you're going to look at the market, value turnover today, net value turnover, meaning you take away the block sales, it hasn't exceeded 5 billion.
Right.
So you can consider it as a tepid value turnover, meaning to say that many investors are still staying on the sidelines. Many investors are still shying away from the market for the time being while waiting for the clouds to dissipate or at least to see some clarifications on what's going to happen moving forward.
Yes, Javed, through all of these inflation numbers that are still stubborn and the rate hikes by the Banco Central and the Fed, the banks had been the superstars for the most part of the last few months. Many investors have been heavy on banks, which are seen as issues that would likely benefit from high interest rate environment. Now, what is the guidance now for banks? Are dips, because we're dipping at these levels, a good opportunity to buy?
Yes, I would recommend buying on dips for the banks because first and foremost, from a value perspective, our banks remain undervalued. Mm-hmm. Many are still trading below their 5-year historical PE ratio averages. So many banks are at bargain levels right now, so it's a good time to accumulate shares. With respect to their growth story, the growth story is still intact. As I mentioned a while ago, given that the economy, despite some challenges, is still expected to remain robust. We still expect loans. We still expect loans to grow, loan portfolios to grow. And this in turn, coupled with high interest rates, is going to boost the bottom line of the banking sector. So in summary, with the banks at bargain levels and with the growth story still intact, I believe they are good options right now. So buck dips is for the banking sector something good to do.
All right. Lastly, other than banks, let's look at the stocks you're covering. Which issues are you seeing strong buy signals this week?
Well, if you're going to look at the sectors, the conglomerates, despite the bargain hunting that we saw today, many are still at undervalued levels. Mm-hmm. If you're going to look at the likes of AC, AEV, SM, these stocks are still at undervalued, still at bargain levels, so it's good to pick them up. At the same time, recently we've seen the telco sector heavily sold off. Mm-hmm. So these are stocks that are also good to accumulate. And finally, finally, the energy sector. Mm-hmm. The energy sector is one of the sectors that we're bullish with right now, given the expectation that the energy market will remain tight, that demand will remain strong amid the economy's post-pandemic expansion, coupled with supply, which remains relatively thin. So energy companies are expected to benefit. So we're also looking into the energy sector. We're recommending it for accumulation.
All right. On that note, Javed Antiago, Fieldstocks Financial, thank you so much for joining us today and for your market guidance.
You're very much welcome, sir. Thank you.